G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, I'm just going to show you how to do Pythagoras in a spreadsheet. So I've got the formula here for Pythagoras. So C squared, can't do superscript in this spreadsheet, so I've had to do it like this. So C squared equals A squared plus B squared. So C squared is generally the hypotenuse of the triangle, and A and B are the other two sides. So as I always do with my formulas, I'm going to start with two figures that I know are going to give me the right answer. So if you know about a 3-4-5 triangle, so if you always have, if you have a triangle with one side that's 3 meters, one side that's 4 meters, you're always going to have a hypotenuse of 5. Okay, so I know that's going to work, so I'll start with that. So as usual, we go down to where we want the answer, and we're always going to start our formula with the equal symbol. And then the first function we're going to do is the square root function. So to get that up, the abbreviation is SQRT. Okay, so you get square root. So click on that, you'll get the brackets come up looking for you to put an answer in. So now the actual thing that we need to square root is A squared plus B squared. So to square something in Excel, we have to use what they call the power function. So we start by writing power, and that operator will come up. We then select the cell that we want the power of. So we want the power of 3 to start with, so we'll click on the cell with 3 in it. Use a little comma symbol, and then we actually put in what we want that to the power of. So because we're squaring it, we're going to put it into the power of 2. Okay. And now that's the end of the first little operation, and then we have to add the b squared. So what you can do is you can close the brackets, put a plus symbol in, and then we need to put the second power in. So we type in power again, get our power function to come up. We're going to click on the cell that's got 4 in it, another little comma, and 2 for the power of 2, and then we're going to close the brackets. So you can see there that that's already telling us that we're going to get the right answer. We're going to get 5 as our answer, okay, because it's done the formula in the background. So we can just hit enter on that now, and we will get our formula, or rather the correct answer. So we know that 3 squared plus the square root of 3 squared plus 4 squared is going to give us 5. Okay, so now we know we've got the right answer there. We can just change our figures. Another one that I know is if we do one there and one there, we should get 1.414, okay? So there we go. We've used a spreadsheet to do Pythagoras and save us a lot of hassle in that way.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.